Hi, do you want to know what makes your clothes shine? How can the same substance be modified as flame retardant as well as explosive? Presenting before you structures and uses of few important phenols. Yes, they find uses right in the medicines, microbiology, diagnostics, all household stuff, and many more. Let's get started. First and foremost, phenol, benzene ring containing hydroxyl group. Phenol can be used along with chloroform in extraction of RNA or DNA based upon the pH of the solution. Even it can be used for removal of few coatings. There are plenty of derivatives which phenol can form, and they find uses like bisphenol A is used in production of polycarbonates, epoxy resins, paint coatings, CDs and all electrical appliances. Alkyl phenols, they are used in detergents, surfactants. Phenolic resins are used to form nylon 6, 66. There are plenty of phenol derivatives which find uses in the cosmetics, in the sunscreens, hair coloring dyes, screen lightening preparations, skin toners. Even bakelite is an important phenol derivative which is used in medical devices like pacemakers, lenses, joint replacement parts, and picric acid. We have seen its structure. That picric acid is used as an explosive. Apart from general uses, as a pharmacy student, you will be interested in knowing medicinal uses. We know it was first used as an antiseptic. So, phenol is a common ingredient in antiseptic, disinfectant, bactericide preparations. It is also used as an analgesic and anesthetic for preparations meant for sore throat, pharyngitis. Hydroquinone, which is a derivative of phenol having hydroxy group at the para position, it is used in the hydroquinone cream which is used for discoloration. Nitrophenols are the precursors for preparing fungicides and pesticides. Phenol is also a starting material to synthesize aspirin, that is acetyl salicylic acid, as well as paracetamol. This beta D salicin is actually a glucoside, but it is a phenolic derivative, popular one, and it is isolated from willow bark. It is known for its anti-inflammatory, antipyretic, and analgesic properties. These are popular brands: Carmex, Chloraseptic, TCP, Hydroquinone, even Dettol. Phenolic groups are also preferred choice of the drugs to convert them in prodrugs. Now, prodrugs are formed to overcome some problems associated with the drugs like solubility problems, bioavailability problems, or stability problems. For example, here we have resveratrol. It is a natural phenol. You can see three phenolic groups over here. And this compound is used as a dietary supplement, but the problem associated with this compound is it gets very rapidly metabolized in the body, so it is not available to show the action. Now we have phenolic groups which can now be converted as carbamate esters. They protect these phenolic groups, so in the body they will get hydrolyzed to again give phenolic groups which can show their action. Phenols can also be converted into esters, sulfates, carbonates, phosphates, and ethers, which can be used to form prodrugs and overcome the problems. Another interesting applications which phenol has given is called as matrixectomy. Now, this application was revealed by observation of the fact that because it is highly toxic in nature, phenol, if it comes in contact with the skin or tissues, it can destroy them. So this has been used positively to treat condition which is called as ingrown toenails. Now this ingrown toenails is there is growth of a nail into the skin or flesh. So phenol as a 5% solution in the vegetable oil has been used for treatment of such nails, and that procedure is called as chemical matrixectomy. And by taking advantage that phenol can destroy the cells, it has been used for treatment of varicose veins or shrinking of the hemorrhoids, because simply it is destroying it. After treatment, it looks something like this, and the disadvantage is this treated part will lose the sensation. But as compared to other treatments, we can see a report over here. Study is almost 20 years back, but traditionally this method is very much famous, because you can see this is the actual report based upon the feedback and the follow-up from the treated patients. So here they have seen, they have concluded that this method of treating this condition with the phenol has been proven as an excellent surgical method because it is simple, having low morbidity and high success rate. Next, we are going to study chrysols. So chrysols are nothing but, apart from phenol, now we have additional methyl group as a substituent. So methyl group can be present at ortho position, named as orthochrysol, metaposition and paraposition. So like phenol, they are also used as antibacterial. Then it has also been used in insecticide preparations. Metacrysol particularly has been widely used in photographic developing plates and explosive. Even these all chrysols have been used in synthesis of carbon nanotubes, and this synthesis has been turned out to be easier without additional chemicals. So because these chemicals are avoided, changes in the properties of these nanotubes, they are also avoided. Coming to the pharmaceutical applications, you can see orthochrysol is used in herbicides. We have amifensin, which is used as a muscle relaxant in case of poisoning. Atomoxetine is used for treatment of ADHD. We have metacrysol, widely used as an antiseptic and disinfectant. Bromocrysol green, which is indicator, popular in acid-based titrations, as well as it can stain albumin, and it is used in diagnosis of kidney failures. Apart from this, it also finds use in microbiology, because this indicator is yellow in color in the acidic medium, and it is blue above pH about 5.5. So it is used as a part of nutrient media, and those organisms which can produce acid, indicator will change the color. So it is widely used for identification of such acid fast bacteria. Then we have one molecule given by Pfizer. This tolimedone was previously used for anti-ulcer, but then its use was stopped for some reasons, and now through repurposing of the drugs, it has been found that it also possesses anti-diabetic properties, and now it is under clinical trials. For paracrysol, we have, it can be used in the synthesis of buprenolol. Then this is one analytical technique, flow cytometry. There paracrysol can be used. Its most prominent use is in the form of BHT. So you can see here tolyl derivative at ortho positions, and because it is paracrysol, we have hydroxy and methyl group in the para position. So at the ortho position, if it is substituted with the tolyl groups, what we get is a very powerful antioxidant used in many preparations, that is called as butylated hydroxytoline, most commonly known as BHT. Coming to resorcinol, more than 50% of the global production of resorcinol is utilized in the rubber industry. So there, resorcinol along with formaldehyde in the form of resins, it is a very popular material for synthesizing adhesives, then tires, conveyor and driving belts. It is also used in synthesis of some chemicals, like hexyl resorcinol is used as a local anesthetic. And these all, like we have seen, crisols are used to synthesize indicator bromocrisol green. Resorcinol is also used in synthesis of some indicators based upon azole and triphenylmethane dyes. Fluorescein is one of such popular indicator. Even some derivatives of resorcinol, that is this compound 2,4-dihydroxybenzophenone, even this beta methyl umbelliferone, these and some other derivatives, they are used in textile industry, and they are used as bleachers or optical brighteners. What they do is they absorb shorter wavelengths and they emit longer wavelengths, but what they emit is perceived by human eyes as a very bright or shiny color. So they are used for usually white and yellow color cloths to appear them more bright. Some derivatives of resorcinol, that is this RDP, resorcinol bis diphenyl phosphate, it is used as a flame retardant and it is installed, it is used in the electronic devices. One derivative, that is trinitroresorcin, it is explosive. Even resorcinol forms part of many, or you can say almost all of the creams which are used to treat skin disorders like acne, then dermatitis, eczema, psoriasis. These are few brand names. Even resorcinol is part of cosmetics, even hair dyes, perfumes. Then we have naphthols. These are containing, instead of benzene, they contain naphthalene and hydroxy group. So this can be either present at alpha position to make it alpha naphthol, and then we also have beta naphthol. So alpha naphthol is a precursor for insecticides like carbaryl. Even it has been used in synthesis of nadolol, then sertraline, atovaquone. Alpha naphthol is also used in qualitative tests like Molish test. Molish test is used as a preliminary test for identification of carbohydrates, and even furfural to confirm the presence of a special kind of carbohydrates. Even it is part of Sakaguchi test, which is used for detection of arginine in the proteins. Voges-Proskauer test, even naphthol, like I told you in case of phenol, whenever there is industrial exposure to all such polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, not only these phenolic derivatives, but say benzene, naphthalene, because these all aromatic hydrocarbons, they are highly toxic in nature, they are converted into phenolic derivatives during metabolism. So these naphthols as well as phenols, they are used as biomarkers. So their content will be tested in the human urine to know what is the exposure level of these polyaromatic hydrocarbons, because during metabolism, Now, these aromatic hydrocarbons will be converted into their polar derivatives, and phenolic derivatives, they are polar in nature. So they are used in assessing this occupational and environmental exposure of the human beings to this toxic polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. Then we have beta naphthol. Like other phenolic derivatives, beta naphthol has also been used in the form of indicator. For example, the range of Sudan dyes, which are based upon diazo group. Then it forms part of tanning agents, antioxidants. Even it has been used as a material precursor for preparations which are used in treatment of alopecia, anthelmintics. It is used in antiseptic in the treatment of scabies. So there are a lot of derivatives of even naphthol which are used as precursor in a wide range of materials like fats, oils, insecticides, pharmaceuticals, perfumes, antiseptics, fungicides, then antioxidants in the rubber. I would recommend, there is a very nice book on only resorcinol, its uses and derivatives, written by Dressler. Then you can read about how phenolic group can be modified for prodrug formation. Then what article I have shown you about resveratrol. Even if you are interested, you can go through this procedure of phenol used in treatment of ingrowing toenail and optical brighteners. So in the next video, we are going to see some more reactions of the phenol which are given by benzene ring by virtue of phenolic group. Till then, stay healthy, stay safe, take care, goodbye.